Ha! Do you know why roses are red?
I'm about to find out.
When the boar mortally wounded Adonis, Aphrodite cried over his body in a meadow filled with flowers. Her tears mixed with Adonis's blood and painted the flowers red.
Do you know why violets are blue? The flowers held their breath, waiting for you to finish one of your stories.
Still hear the screams of mortals fleeing, while the Caledonian boar ravaged their countryside and destroyed all their harvests. All because King Onias forgot to make an offering to Artemis.
Mm-hmm.
Adonis would have been wise not to spend so much time with Aphrodite. She had many jealous lovers.
Yeah, well, she wasn't in love with his brains.
He couldn't best the boar sent by jealous Ares. But when a sad Aphrodite poured nectar over Adonis's wounds, out sprang the gorgeous anemone.
Adonia! Ah! The smelliest of festivals, totally appropriate for Adonis. He didn't belong with Aphrodite, she was better than him.
Adonia was a celebration of women's self-expression. They would dance on the rooftops, bringing scented plants like fennel and cabbage to their parties. In the spirit of Adonia, isn't it Aphrodite's choice who she loves?
Not when it's rotten, like that smell.
And yet, the women of these villages let it waft from the rooftops, year after year. Maybe the freedom to make the choice is what matters.
Your broken world does not deserve my perfection, but I am kind.
Phoenix would have to participate in the festival to open up to Adonia if the vault itself was to open.
That little turn of phrase and you light up like a pomegranate tree. Oh, I see you, Prometheus.
You have your pleasures and I have mine. Deep within the vault, Phoenix found one of the tears Aphrodite shed over Adonis.
I really don't think Adonis... was worth all this crying. It was just a pretty face.
Phoenix left the vault victorious, tear in hand,
smelling only faintly of cabbage.